Ion mobility is great because it's separating the ions on their size, the shape, and their charge. So how does that fit into a mass spec experiment?
Okay, well, you can think of ion mobility separations in an analogous manner to other chromatographic separations, such as LC or capillary electrophoresis. So what we do is send a packet of the analyte effectively into the separation region, and that's what we're doing with ion mobility. We send a packet of ions into the mobility cell where the field is. They separate according to their mobility, and then they exit that device in a time fashion, and we can detect them. In our case, we use the mass spectrometer, the time of flight analyzer, to do that.
So we're getting complementary information to regular mass spec experiments, but what are the other benefits that we need to talk about?
Yeah, well, it's fast. I mean, that's one of the beauties of mobility separation. It takes place on the sort of tens of milliseconds timescale because it's occurring in the gas phase. And so this is obviously much shorter than the typical LC experiments. And so we can easily sample a chromatographic experiment because we can get many mobility experiments that run across the peaks that occur in LC.
So that's what people mean when they say it's nested.
That's right, yeah, we can. Yeah, that's exactly it. So this gives us added peak capacity or separative capability. And this can be really useful if you've got complex samples. It allows you to separate species better and delve down deeper into the samples for things that otherwise perhaps would have been hidden by large other species that are present within the sample. But it's also useful for direct sample introduction techniques such as MALDI or DESI, where you don't have any chromatography up front. You can use the mobility separation in the instrument to give some degree of separation for those samples. And finally, you can use mobility separation to get collision cross-section values. We'll talk about this at a later date, I guess, but this can give you structural information on the species that are in the gas phase, which can be extremely useful. So that's pretty much my thoughts on that. Do you think we need to do anything else?
I think that covers it, and perhaps we'll just have to address CCS as a separate topic.
Okay.